Hi, everyone. Welcome to State of the Market. I'm Mark Lichtenfeld, Chief Income Strategist of the Oxford Club. Before we begin, make sure you subscribe to this channel. That way, you'll be sure not to miss my next two videos coming out over the next 2 weeks, my top stocks to avoid in 2022 and my top stocks to buy for 2022. Now, usually that kind of stuff comes out in December or January, but I'm giving you a head start on everyone else beginning next week. So click on that subscribe button so you don't miss it, and it's absolutely free. Now, what do investors love more than anything? Penny stocks and dividends. And they're not easy to find. Even though a lot of people love them, most penny stocks are garbage.
Yes, I love trash.
But there are a few out there that are real companies that pay shareholders income, but the stocks are so low priced that investors can buy lots of shares and take advantage of big price movements. I get it. Like Van Halen says, you want the best of both worlds. There are just under 5,000 stocks in the United States that currently trade below $10. Of those, 223 pay dividends, so they're quite rare, like a good David Spade movie.
What?
That being said, there are some solid penny stocks that pay strong dividends. Now let's take a look at some of the top ones. My top yielder is ticker symbol GOGL. No, that's not Google, it's Golden Ocean Group. Very different. Google trades at about $2,900 a share. Golden Ocean, under $9. Now, Golden Ocean Group is a Bermuda-based shipping company with 101 vessels. Its dividend is variable, but so far it's been impressive. In the first quarter of this year, it paid 25 cents per share and upped it to 50 cents in the second quarter. Now, it has not yet announced third quarter results or its dividend. Annualizing the dividends from the first two quarters gives the stock a 16.8% yield, though keep in mind there is no guarantee that the remaining dividends will be equal to the first half of the year. But with a shortage of everything these days and prices going higher, it's likely that container ships are going to be in high demand in the near future, so I'd expect more solid payouts from Golden Ocean Group. All right, my next one is a bit unusual. It's Peruvian cement company Cementos Pacasmayo, ticker symbol CPAC. The company is 72 years old, and an interesting factoid, it was taken over by the military government in 1973, and it broke the shackles of government control in 1984. Okay, enough Cementos Pacasmayo trivia, let's get to the dividend. In June, it paid $1 per ADR, which at today's price, which is a little under $6, equals a stunning yield of 15.8%. Last year, the dividend was substantially less, paying just 32 cents per share. The year before that, 50 cents. So the dividend is going to move a lot, and it's only paid once per year. But considering the post-COVID growth around the world, I'd expect investors to continue to receive a dividend that's muy bueno. Now, just be careful, as this one only trades about 26,000 shares a day, so it's not the most liquid stock out there. Orchid Island Capital, ticker symbol ORC. That's the next one, and this is a $5 stock with a big 15.6% yield. This is a mortgage REIT that has paid 6.5 cents per share monthly since April 2020. Prior to that, the dividend was 8 cents per share, and the dividend has steadily come down over recent years, but that could be about to change. Low interest rates and tight spreads make it difficult for mortgage REITs to make money. Now, tight spreads are when the difference between short and long-term interest rates are narrow, and that's been the case for a number of years. It's beginning to change. As inflation goes higher, so should rates, and we're already starting to see those spreads widen. So Orchid Island Capital should make more money over the coming years, and its dividend could even increase if it does. So you've got three big double-digit yields on very low-priced stocks. Now remember, sky-high yields and very low-priced stocks often come with additional risk, so make sure you invest accordingly. But for those that want the best of both worlds, this is a good place to start. And don't forget, next week I'll have my top stocks to avoid in 2022, followed by top stocks to buy the following week. For more wealth and income building ideas, check out Wealthy Retirement. It's absolutely free. Just click on the link below. I'm Mark Lichtenfeld. I'll see you next week with my top stocks to avoid in 2022.